All right, we're back again. Let's Paint TV. All right, so much stuff we got to do here today. Let's see if we can try to get some of it done. All right, let me just see what I can do. No space. No room. Oh, gosh. So much stuff to do. Got a mess. What's going on? Bongo. All right. Jeez. Trying to organize. Feels like every time I come back in this mess is like I'm organizing. All right. Let's see. I got to do some work. What temperature over there? I'd say it's 62 degrees. I really don't know. It's not too cold. And it's not too hot. I'd say it's in its 60s. We are in the 60s. Okay, so let me go see. I gotta go over to Damn it. All right. I'm not painting anything today. I'm organizing. And that's exciting. Okay, let me go down here to, hopefully I can find this. Take your time. Here we go. Let's see if we can find this information.
Let's see. Spotlight shirts. Let's see here. What am I looking at? In the show title, yes. Where is that? It's a movie? Where are you? It's there, but where? Let's see if I can do it this way. Import? Media, maybe? Let's see this. This is what I want. Import selected. Where did you go? I put you down there into the project. How do we do it now? Ah, no. No. What do we do? Shit.
Damn it. So, let's see how I'm going to do this. I guess we got to go new projects. That's what we're doing. All right, let's try that. Now we can drop it. There, how about that? See if we can do any kind of fixing. In there. I don't know if we can. Might not be able to fix it, but that's the problem. It's not. Darn that. Thank you.
about.
Okay, well, I'm getting there. It's almost, I'm almost resolving what I need to do. And this is just a tip. All right, let's get some water. Oh, that was good. All right. Shit. Okay. Darn. How can I find the... It's not lower thirds. Ah, scrolling. That's what I want. There we go. Scrolling, thank you. Scrolling, okay. So then, let's go over here. But this thing says, special thanks to our supporters like you. So let's go over here. Thank you. gonna work. So, let's see. I'm gonna go ahead and send it out. I gotta go over here one more time. It's okay. So now we got the end of show titles. I had lost them, and so now we got them back again. Not many. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Not many. Not many of you. We lost a few of them. So, mission accomplished for today. See that rebound? Yeah. I had someone added $1, a new person, and then we lost a few people. So it's good to clean up my. Well, okay. What happened was is that I had a somewhat of a computer meltdown. What happened was I had filled up all the space on the computer, and once that happens, then you can't do anything because the computer is full. And so I had to figure out how to get everything out of there. And in doing so, I lost a lot of stuff, which was no big deal. And I lost that file. So I basically had to redo it again. And but by doing it, it made me realize there were a few people that had actually... We're not supporting the program anymore, which is fine. I was thinking about getting rid of it anyway, but for the time being, we'll keep it. Okay, mission accomplished there. Yeah, I had about five people that had stopped paying, and I was still giving them support. Let's take this call. Hello, caller, you're on Let's Paint TV.
Hi there.
Hello.
Welcome.
Okay, are you?
It's fantastic to be on your show. My name's Rory. I've been a big fan of yours for many years.
Okay, hey, Rory. What's going
on? It's a thrill to speak to you today. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. Doing good. Just trying.
What are we painting today?
Well, I'm more or less organizing. It's more like, let's organize today.
Now, are we doing any exercising or blending drinks? Or are we strictly organizing today?
Yeah, it's just strictly organizing today.
Okay, that's fun. You know, sometimes I find when I need a little boost, I need a little inspiration, I can, give my office a revamp, take a new look at things.
I'm in the middle, and it feels like the past, I think the last 10 years of my life has felt like I'm just reshuffling stuff around and organizing and trying to find the right feng shui, the correct feng shui.
Sure. Sure. And so what's your goal today? What are you seeking to do? What are you trying to lock down?
Well, I just did, wasn't really terrible, you know, you couldn't see what I was doing, but I had updated the credits for the end of the program for the supporters, restructured that, and so that's going to, I just ran that just a second ago. And so that's one, job number one. I also picked up the garbage that was on the floor, and I think I'm going to go pick up a little basket, because I was just throwing stuff on the ground, and I'm going to get like a waste paper basket today from the 99-cent store.
Fantastic. You know, I find that too sometimes. You know, I'm doing a lot of writing, I'm doing a lot of drafts. I have a bad idea. I don't want that on the floor. I want that in a basket. So I think that's phenomenal. You know, you're going to reach out, you're going to go into that world, you're going to find something, find a place for that trash, you know, because that you know, as an artist, you're talking about your feng shui, that's going to help you stay focused, that's going to help you center yourself, and that's going to help you get on with your day and keep that energy up. I think that's fantastic.
Yeah, it is, but it's frustrating because I in some ways would prefer to just go and kind of like find another shell to procreate in, because I feel like this one has already been used up. It's chock. I'm up to the gills with.
John, if I can ask you this, I want you to describe for me your dream space. I want you to describe for me, if you could walk into a room, where do you want to create? What do you want to do?
Something that void of all this artwork. I got too much artwork in this space. That's the real deal. And
you want the tabula rasa. You want the blank slate. You want to come in with no preconceptions and you just want to go to town.
Yeah, I want to stink it up, because right now I have already stunk it up. It's like going into a porta potty that is chock full.
Absolutely.
As opposed to going to a porta potty that is ready for business, you know, right? You know,
you want the smell of the vinyl and the plastic seating and the chemicals in there.
Yes.
You want the full.
I don't want to see anything but just like a blue chemical, a pool,
exactly.
Splash up to my in my ass.
Exactly. I think that's a fantastic note to end on. I want to thank you for speaking to me today. I take a lot of inspiration from you. I feel like I've learned a lot today. So I hope you have a great day.
I hope you do too.
Okay. Fantastic.
Thank you. Take care. Well, that was fun. If you guys want to call, you can. 818-528-4516. It is true. I just spent the last half an hour. Oh, we got another call. Let's get another call. Hello, caller. You're on Let's Paint TV.
Hello, sir.
Hello. Hello. Hi. Hi. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
I'm calling. My name is Rory. I'm calling from Toronto.
Toronto. What's going on?
Yep. Not much.
Good. So you just
it's
been
on delay. I'm so confused.
Yeah.
I gotta turn down this volume.
Yeah. Just ignore the volume. The volume.
I thought you were a call screener.
Yeah. Well, I
thought I was talking to Gary Delabonte, Baba Booey.
No. It's just little old me.
Can I ask you, can you hear what my laptop is doing right now? Do you hear that noise? Do you know what that could be? I know you paint and stuff, but do you know what that could be? Do you hear that?
No,
it sounds like a lawnmower.
No, I'm not really hearing anything.
Let me hold it right up to the phone. You can't hear that?
I heard that. That's like a buzzer.
Yeah. You know that scene in Dumb and Dumber where he goes, the most annoying sound in the world, and he goes, ah! That's
no.
My laptop does, like, all yeah. day.
Yeah. So there's something wrong with your laptop, is what you're saying.
I mean, it's getting really hot. It does, like, your screen is freezing.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I thought.
Well, that'd be good for TikTok Tech Talk time, 3 after the hour. We could talk about technology and stuff. My recommendation is just get a new computer.
I'm not rich.
Yeah, well, who is? But you want to keep up to date, up to speed with social.
When it says that they have updates to install, that's what I'm supposed to do?
You might want to do that. How old is your computer?
At least, I think, like 6 years old.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a Mac.
Yeah, Mac. Even a Mac that's 6 years old is going to be pushing it. And you're just going to have to break down and get a new one.
I'm running OS X4.
Yeah, that sounds like old, right? Isn't that old?
Kind of.
Wait.
Kind of. I got dock magnification on.
Yeah, that sounds like some ancient. That sounds like DOS or something. That sounds like bit.
No. It's 64. No,
oh, okay. You should be running like, you know, like 10 or something.
Did you say it's tech time at 3 after the hour? It's 3:04. So
well, it's 4 after. It's 4 after the hour now. I mean, we've been talking for a minute, so.
Oh, right. I got 2 minutes deep in my friends the other night. You know what I mean?
2 minutes deep into your friend? 2 minutes?
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty good. 2 minutes.
Yeah.
How much?
I mean, it's not a marathon.
How much
you're
in and out?
To get an end result.
How much in and out was going on in that 2 minutes? Was just.
I mean, I can get a lot accomplished. I'm not gonna lie to you.
All right,
bro.
All right. Good talking to you.
Keep watching. I don't want to take up too much of your time. I just thought you might be able to know what that.
Yeah. I'm not a Mac genius or a Genesis or whatever that is.
Do you know Steve Phil, Dotto?
No, but Phil Collins. I think Phil Collins works at the Genesis bar at Apple.
He's deaf.
Is he?
Yeah, he got deaf from drumming. That's why he had to quit.
Oh.
It's like what happened to Bowie, except he can still walk around a little.
Well, I mean, I guess he's up in the clouds or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ground control to Major Bowie. All right, my man.
All right, good
I love
talk.
Your stuff.
All right, thank you, buddy.
Paint something for me, will you?
Yeah, I know. I'm just trying to organize today. I'm just organizing.
Oh, you're getting a waste paper basket, right?
Yeah, that's my big deal.
You know what I got in my waste paper basket? I got a steak sandwich that was riddled with onions. I told them no onions.
Yeah.
And there's like more onions than steak on there, but you don't need to know about my worries.
Well, they dogged
my
you.
Laptop.
They basically dogged you.
They did dog me, but that's okay. Yeah. I've got some Maynard sour peaches and some grapefruit juice and a Nas energy drink, so I'll be
all
up
right.
for days.
All right, yeah, get your vitamin C. Get your vitamin C in you.
I'm going to get some caffeine, some taurine, some guarana, some L-theanine, and some vitamin B6 in my shit.
Nice.
Peace.
Peace out, buddy. All right, we're going to get a couple little flurry, a phone call flurry. Wow. It's amazing how things can start to pick up once we go through the whole program. Our time is in many respects, for all intents and purposes, our time is up. But it usually takes us a whole hour to get going, so I guess we could go a little longer. I was, as you say, just organizing things, so that's where I'm at. Contemplating making some serious moves here, but I think I just need to move some of these paintings around. It's just endless. Okay, so anyway. Well, I guess, is that where we're at? Are we at there? Are we there? What's going on? Not much. Okay, well, we got one thing done, which is good. And now it's just a matter of, should we hang up, close up shop, or take another call? Let's take another call. Hello, caller, you're on Let's Paint TV.
Is this Let's Paint?
Yes, this is Let's Paint TV.
I was calling to get some tips on a bit of a portrait that I'm up to right now.
Oh, okay. All right. Sure.
Just wondering if you have any tips for realistic shading.
Are you using pencil or?
I'm using charcoals, pencils mainly, some charcoals.
Okay. And you're looking for shading properties?
For shading test. I want to get a realistic rendering of my friend, his name's Ren, and I wanted to give him a gift.
Yeah.
Of his portrait, and I wanted to be real. I want realistic rendering.
Have you ever drawn before? I mean, how experienced are you with the?
I'd say somewhat experienced.
Yeah.
But what I have trouble with, John, is I have trouble with the nose. He has a very bulbous nose, and I'm finding it hard to just get the directionality of the light and the mood and the tone of the room. And I'm wondering if you have any tips.
Well, how many various lights are hitting that nose? Does it does that nose have such a prominent element that the surprise is not really there anymore, because it's so big, it's like the elephant in the room, and if that's the then you want to like simplify, squint your eyes is what I would recommend. Squint your eyes to see maybe the primal shape of that nose.
Bit of a squint, I like that.
Yes,
like that.
Squint. Squint your eyes, and so that you only let a little bit of the light in.
A little bit of the light. I like that because, I like working in the black and the white. I don't like the color so much. That's very helpful. Now, John, I have one more question for you.
Yeah, sure.
Because this is a gift, if Rand doesn't like my, my drawing of him, he can be a very sensitive friend.
Yeah.
How do I approach that? How do I approach that?
Well, with Michael Jackson gloves on, Michael Jackson white gloves with little rhinestones on it. That's how I'd approach it. Just with kid gloves on.
Yeah.
Maybe a latex free glove that you could just throw away. Maybe more of an inexpensive. Those blue nitrate gloves are really good. That's what I like, the nitrate gloves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
Michael Jackson. He's a little scary. Sometimes I find him a little scary. When I was a kid, I saw his videos on the TV. I got scared.
Yeah.
He's got the gloves and he's got these eyes, and that's another thing I've been having a problem with, John, is really rendering the eyes.
Yeah.
Whether they're scary or whether they're, more of a friendly eye.
Yeah, yeah.
I have trouble with that too.
Yeah, the eye of the tiger. These are things where you just have to persevere, my friend, and not let it get to you, the imperfections and inconsistencies, incongruencies, elements that may or may not live up to your own manifestations. We must have lost them. I guess he was happy with my response. Thanks for calling 818-528-4516. You're watching Let's Paint TV. We're going a little longer because I got nothing else to do, basically. I'm going to go to the 99-cent store and look for a waste paper basket that will probably help out in my feng shui-ing. But really what I need more than anything else is clear out all these paintings. I got, I must have like 200 paintings in here that I would love to just cash in if I could just cash in. We got another call. Hello, caller. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Oh, this is the Toronto guy again with the laptop.
What's up, Toronto?
I have a question for you because you're talking on the one thing, but every time, like you were standing up, but it keeps going back. See, right there. Oh, I'm ahead of your, remember, I have a delay on my thing.
Oh.
But there's a picture of you sitting there with the fan, but you're standing up in like the live camera. What's going on there?
Oh, well, let me just see what's going on. I had not been really watching the live feed. I've just been sort of figuring it was doing its own thing. But yeah, it looks like I'm,
a slideshow.
Yeah, I'm stuck on one of those shots. That's like a stationary shot. Isn't that interesting? I'm not sure what that is all about, but there is a stoppage of time.
And you're moving. I can see you standing. Yeah. You got your hands on your hips, like you don't give a shit.
Exactly. So I mean, that is okay. So it's this shot here is
that
this
one.
That's
there it
stuck.
Is.
That's a stuck on you. It was fixated, and it must have saw something really fascinating on the internet. And as
okay.
such,
I saw you said you didn't have. I didn't want to call you back and bug you, but you said that you were just going to go long. So I just had one more question.
Yeah.
That fan that was there. Have you ever turned that thing on and put your voice next to it and heard what happens when you're talking to it?
I have. No, that is. I have done that. Yes, I have.
I smoked something one time and sat near a fan and talked to it like it was my best friend for at least 20 minutes.
It is kind of
my laptop, actually.
It is kind of fun, I gotta say. It is a fun experience. It's something that we all should do once.
Is that like a Dandy Warhol that they keep showing there with those 9 pictures? Is that a Dandy Warhol? Right there.
Yeah, and Andy Warhol. Dandy? Did you say Dandy or Andy?
Who?
Andy or Dandy?
No, my name's Adam.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, you were saying that maybe you're thinking that's a Dandy Warhol?
No. My name's Adam.
Yeah, but the paintings.
Oh, I see what you mean. I'm sorry. Yeah, Andy Warhol.
Okay, it sounded like you said Dandy.
No, I'm saying it's a Dandy Andy Warhol.
Oh, Dandy Andy, yeah. Oh, no.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, these are some paintings of these. Those are my paintings that I'm doing a bakery. And
wait,
so...
You can eat them?
Well, you can't really eat them, but you could at least look at them and salivate at looking at them, and then break down and go to the local donut shop and get some donuts and sweets and stuff like that, and shove your face.
So if I go in there and say, "Let's Paint TV sent me," I'm going to get a scone.
You could get whatever you want. I don't, you know, and maybe you could get a discount if you do. You have your creativity card.
A creativity card?
Yeah.
Bitch, I was born with that.
Okay, well, I used to... You can make your own, but if you don't have one, it's real easy to make. Just cut out a card out of, you know, construction paper. And I've had this in my wallet for probably the past 10 years.
You got to show it at the border? Like, I'm Canadian, so you, if I come
you
to
can
you, I got to, like, show them
just,
that?
Just show
Whoa,
them. When you
is.
Go to Tim Hortons and stuff... Just yeah. show them your creativity card for 10% off.
They're gonna throw me out of my ass. They're gonna throw me right out of my Canadian ass.
That's
right
all right. That's all right. It's all in fun. It's all in fun. That
creativity card looks. How long have you had that?
Yeah, it's definitely disintegrated quite a bit. I need to update my creativity card, but it is there.
Here's my question: are you available for commission?
Yeah.
Touch with you for drawing.
Well, yeah.
But I can't do that stuff. It's upside down, bro.
Oh, all right.
That's not. I mean, unless you're being creative with it.
Well, that is a good point. And that's the beauty.
I should have yes-anded your creativity.
That is the beauty about creativity. Creativity is that you can be experimental. That is a big part of creativity.
Yeah, until people don't like it, then they want you creatively to change your flow.
Right. Well, but don't let them ruin your parachute.
Let's paint
you know what I mean?
For you and me, I can rap live and crap. This is how I do my creativity, you see?
Nice. That's good.
And I'm out.
Good, good, good. I like that. There he goes. Give us a call, 818-528-4516. I'll be here just a tad bit longer. And got any more chats in the chat room? Okay. I'll check my emails. Not much going on over there. All right, let's take another call. Here we go. Hello, caller. You're on Let's Paint TV.
Hi, this is Ben from Toronto. How are you?
Ben from Toronto. What's going on? We got a lot of Toronto coming in.
A lot of Toronto, that's right. Yeah. I don't have a lot of time, but I just thought I'd call in, make a quick comment. I noticed you were painting today is that a strawberry shortcake?
It's actually a strawberry mousse cake.
Oh,
yeah.
Delicious.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you know, it's not, it looks more delicious than it actually tastes. It, I'm gonna be throwing this, by the way, in the garbage can.
No, listen, yeah. Don't do that. It's something you created.
Well, I didn't.
It's something you made.
I didn't make it.
And I don't think you should toss it away.
Well, I bought it at the local supermarket, the cake. It's just.
Oh, I was talking about the painting.
Oh, the painting.
If you want
to
throw the cake away,
yeah,
go ahead.
Yeah, I'm throwing the cake away because I'm not looking forward to, you know, like eating a bunch of sugar, straight up sugar. That's all it is just a bunch of sugar.
Yeah, I mean, sugar will do it to you. You know, you'll crash quick.
Yeah.
But it's funny. It's funny that you've kind of reminded me of something from a few years ago. A friend of mine had this idea. I wanted to get your opinion on it. He said, "Wouldn't it be great if there was a style of painting or like a movement that isn't? It's not paintings of food, but it's paintings that look so delicious that you would want to eat them, and you'd call it deliciousism." And I always thought that was such an interesting idea.
Yeah.
You know, like, could you paint something that isn't like a literal painting of something you'd eat, but it just looks so appetizing that you would want to eat it?
Right.
And I think that's incredible. So I think, you know, you could, if you wanted to move towards something, a little more abstract, you could do that.
Right. Well, you could take that even further. You could have, you could make it so luscious, like a figure of whatever, you know, inspires you in terms of sexuality, where then you would then, you know, want to have, you know, make love to the painting. That'd be cool.
Sure, that's kind of like an R-rated deliciousism. Well, that's like a little more adult, but
or even X-rated if you go that, go, you know, a little
sure.
more money shot.
NC-17.
Yes.
This is great. You know, this is my first time I've ever tuned into this.
Well, why are you watching this show? Where are you guys coming from? You guys are coming out of the woodwork today.
Yeah, I was just told about it. A friend of a friend said, "You got to check out Let's Paint TV."
Okay.
I said, "What's that?" He sent me the link to it, and I love this. You know, I love technology. I love communication.
Yeah.
I love this sort of instantaneous contact we can have. I love that you take calls. You know, we're in this age now where everybody's watching stuff. It's all pre-recorded.
Yeah.
I like this sort of live interaction that you do.
Yeah, I like it too. I mean, I feel like though I'll go days and days with no interaction, and that just, it really, you know, kind of makes me think maybe I shouldn't be doing this anymore. And then I have a day like this, and you know, my mama told me there'd be days like these. My mama told
days like this. Mama said,
"Yes."
Hey, listen. I know that sometimes things can get a little discouraging. You know, I think we all have days like that.
Yes.
We all have days like this.
Yes.
But you know, I honestly, like, I had no idea about this show. I think it's great that you're doing it, and you know, keep fighting the good fight. Don't let the quieter days get you down. Just keep pushing on. This is fantastic.
Fantastic. Thank you so much. Thanks for
You're
the
very
encouragement.
Welcome. Thank you for taking my call. I really appreciate it.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Toronto in the house. I love Toronto. I've been fortunate, lucky enough to be there a couple of times, handful of times, and look forward to going back there again. Maybe not like now per se, because I'm a big wimp in terms of weather. I'm a weather wimp, and I don't think I'd fare too well in a bunch of snow all the time. But actually, it would be kind of fun maybe for a day or two. Maybe I'd do it. Maybe I'd go for it. All right. Anyway, 818-528-4516. Anyway, I got a ton of paintings here, and there is something to be said about clearing out your space so that you can resurrect oneself. Let's take another call. Hello, caller. You're on Let's Paint TV. Hi.
Hey. I don't have so much of a question, more of a comment.
Sure.
But I just wanted to swing by if I can.
Yeah.
Has anyone ever told you? Anyone ever told you that you look like someone else?
Yeah. You know, it changes over the years. You know, you look like different people here and there. So.
You tell me. You know, I'm curious who tell you.
Oh. at one time someone said they said I looked like Clint Eastwood when I was really young, and then now I look more like Mr. Bean.
Oh, Mr. Bean, he's funny. He's so funny.
And he's so funny. And then, you know, that's about it. And so I've gone from Clint Eastwood to Mr. Bean. So I'm I'm looking for something. I'm trying to get back up on the.
I'm trying to get halfway.
I mean, maybe I could get in somewhere in the middle now.
You know, maybe you have the Google open.
I do. I mean, I can open it, I guess.
Open up the Google. Check this out.
All right.
Type in William. Okay.
Well, let me. I'm not there yet.
You might have to. Yeah, we'll just wait.
All right. William, is that W I L L I M?
That's right. William McDonald, like McDonald's, the food, but it's just one. And then actor. And you're going to type that in, and then you're going to click images.
McDonough.
No, I'm so sorry. William McDonald, like the French fry.
All right.
Yeah, William McDonald, actor.
Actor.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Oh, Mr. Bean.
There is a William McDonald, a serial killer.
No. You want to click on the images. So at the top where it says images.
Yeah. Believe it or not, there is a ceiling. Okay, here we go. Images. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Sure.
So there's a guy there. You know, he looks like a lot of fun. He looks like a lot of fun. He was in the X Files. Have you seen the X Files ever? You seen that show?
Yeah.
The X Files.
A long time ago, right?
Yeah. The X Files is one of my favorite shows. He was in the Millennium. He was in The Outer Limits. That was a scary one. It was a little scary. I like Mr. Bean more than some of these shows. He was so, he's such a fun actor, and I think it's fun sometimes, you know, people tell you look like someone, you look like Clint Eastwood or Mr. Bean.
Gotcha.
I think today that you look a little bit like William McDonald.
Well, maybe when they make a movie about Mr. Let's Paint, maybe he would play myself. Maybe we could do that.
He could play yourself. Who do you want to direct that biopic?
Wim Wenders.
Wim Wenders.
Yeah, why not?
He is so.
No, Spike Lee. Spike Lee.
Spike Lee.
Yeah.
You know, my old boy is so much fun. I think that's such a fun movie. Wim Wenders, he made a movie called Paris, I think, and that's another fun movie.
Yeah, I know. I don't really know much about him. Who is there's a okay. few of these people that I'm not familiar. I just threw that name out. Noam Chomsky, but I realized that he doesn't really do that kind of work.
You could get Noam Chomsky to make a videotape, like a docudrama.
Yeah.
You know, he might come out and see the green screen in the studio. You know, he could do something.
You know what I'd like to do with what I'd like to do with Noam Chomsky is eat chop suey with him.
Oh, you'd have a bibimbap.
Yes.
Have you ever seen one of those?
No.
A bibimbap, it's a hot pot. It's noodles. You could, if you have the Google open, you can look at that too. Having a meal with any of those guys would be so much fun.
Yeah, I think it would be kind of fun.
They're all creative minds. You know, you could get so much inspiration.
Yeah, I'm really keen with, I'd like to hang out with is Neil deGrasse High.
Oh, he was on, you just reminded me of the Drake. You guys get Drake down there?
Drake? The drink or the rapper, right? The racker?
The rapper. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
He was on, I think he did a movie with Neil deGrasse.
Oh, nice.
Excellent. So that's a lot of fun. Well, you know, watch one of William's movies. I think he's really fun. I think it's funny that someone told you that you look like Mr. Bean. I think that's a lot of fun.
Yeah, because I got a nice receding hairline and... I guess, you know, at times I can somewhat be slightly comical of sorts, I guess. I don't know. Or
there was an episode that was so funny. It was so much fun where he had a turkey. Do you know this one? It reminds me of your show a little bit.
No, I mean, he did a lot of stuff. The only thing is he never really talked, right? Is that his deal? He never talked?
No, he doesn't talk. He never talks.
Yeah,
that's part of the mystique. Part of the legend.
Yeah, that gets tiresome. I get tired of that stuff.
I get tired of that.
Yeah,
too. You know, he's for little boys and girls. You know,
maybe so. Yeah,
give us some of the adult. Give us some of the blue jokes. You know, that's kind of what I tune in for.
Yeah. So, you ever see Blue Collar?
Blue Collar?
Yeah, the movie with Richard Pryor in it.
Oh, we got Richard Pryor. Harvey Keitel is one of my favorite actors.
Yeah.
He had a poster of him growing up.
It's a good movie.
They're so funny in that movie.
Well, it's not, I don't know how funny it was, but it was pretty good. Blue Collar.
You know, they have a big heist plan. That's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I remember it was the steel auto workers in Detroit. It's a good movie.
That's right. I'll check it out. Thanks for the recommendation.
Yeah.
Thanks for your show.
Yeah, another movie I would recommend is Damnation Alley.
Okay.
Yeah.
Damnation.
Alley. Yeah.
Okay.
It's like a nuclear holocaust afterwards kind of movie.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The thing I noticed about you is that you like a lot of the 70s movies.
Well,
you like a lot of the adventures.
Yeah, yeah. You know? I am kind of a child of the 70s.
That's a lot of fun. Thanks for the tips and
yes.
thanks for the call.
You got it.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Let's get another call in here. Hello, caller. You're on Let's Paint TV.
I just had a great... It's me again with the laptop. I was watching. I had a great idea what to do with that cake.
Yes.
Get a canvas and throw that bitch. Please?
Yeah, that's a great idea. I'm not going to deny it. I've been there, done that.
I said please.
I've seen people do it. I just don't want to do that. I don't want to do that. That's like me growing a goatee. I've done it before. I'm not going to do it now.
Sir, I'm going to have to ask you to turn into your creativity card. One more thing. What about Kevin Pollak? You kind of look like
Kevin Pollak. Yeah, is that the guy who
casino?
Is he the guy
casino,
every?
He has a chat talk.
Is he the guy who does every 4th of July? He has support our troops. Big. Does he like one of those big support our troops kind of guy? I think so. No, or am I mixing?
Oh man,
No, that's Gary Sinise. Yep, that's Gary. Gary Sinise. Gary Sinise. He's like.
Gary Sinise?
Yeah, he's really big. Mark. He's all big on
that's
support.
What they make the astronaut ships on him. This leg is what they make the astronaut ship on, of course. It's my sea legs.
Oh, I didn't know.
That's what Gary Sinise says in Forrest Gump.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's his claim to fame, I think.
Yeah, at the end, he's at the wedding, and he pulls up his leg, and he's got a little
his
hanger up there.
His big mission for now is to, help out Iraq war veterans and stuff like that. And
prove it.
So there you go.
All right.
Hey, thanks for the call. Thanks for the call. Again. We usually don't let we usually one call a day kind of deal, but I guess I'm having fun with the calls. I think it's just the two guys calling back and forth, aren't they? Or did we have a third call coming in? Anyway, you're welcome to call 818-528-4516. I'm just trying to organize my life as usual. A daily chore. And I don't believe we'll be on much longer because I'm going to have to go get that waste paper basket. So, if you're going to call, you better call in the next 2 minutes because I'm going to be checking out of this portal, and then geez, I will be trying to rearrange my situation. We did a little bit. We did. I gotta say, I don't feel so bad, and I really enjoy taking your calls. I really brings me back to the day when I had people call. When I had people actually calling the program, it's fun. It's exciting to interact with a fellow human being. So I thank you for the calls. I thank you for coming in and hanging out here today with us. And we will see you again tomorrow here on Let's Paint TV. Maybe I'll be inspired to actually paint, though don't count on it, but it's possible. At some point, you know what, if you hold back and you don't do something that you love to do for a while, it will come out and you will end up wanting to do it again. So it's not a bad idea to not do anything. But in my case, I just need to move some stuff around, and it's just a really difficult situation because there's really nowhere to put the stuff. That's probably the hardest thing to and I don't want to throw it away, and I guess I want to sell it or something. Maybe I'll have to donate it. I don't know. Maybe I'm not going to donate it. Okay. All right, last call, or if there's another one, call. Let's take this. Hello, caller. You're on Let's Paint TV. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hey, how's it going?
All right.
I'm Frank.
Frank.
Very nice to talk to you. Big fan.
Nice.
Are you taking requests? How does this work?
Well, I'm just taking the call. That's all. I mean, I'm not doing any painting right now. I'm trying.
Can I just throw something out there? So I watched this interview with Sean Penn the other day.
Yeah.
On Charlie Rose.
Yeah,
his
yeah.
Face. It was just filled with such. I don't even know how to describe it in words, but it was an incredible look of almost despair.
Yeah.
I would love to see you paint that someday.
Sean Penn. Yeah, I saw that too. Yeah, that was interesting. Yeah. He almost looked like it looked like he had a some kind of crazy mask on his face, and his eyes were coming through this mask. It was like it was a very strange face, I gotta say. But I thought it was genuine. I didn't. You know, I'm willing to like him. I mean, I guess people hate him and stuff, but.
Oh, there's a lot of depth in there. There's like.
Yeah, it was deep. He was deep. Yeah. He was putting out some interesting wordage that I thought was fascinating.
He had a couple of interesting little sentence structures that really hit home with me. I really quite liked what he said in some cases.
Oh man!
Don't ask me to repeat it, but I just liked some of the wording that he was throwing out. I thought it was very well contrived, conceived, thought out.
He's a poet.
He didn't even know it.
Exactly. And Charlie Rose's face would be good too. I feel like there's a lot going on there.
Yeah, well, there is. And talk about, and actually both faces, they have the melt face, like their face, their skin and their face is melting off their skeletal structure. And then their soul, their souls are, you know, their eyes are still coming through, but they're just like sagging. They're sagging. They're sagging. They're getting old. They're getting old, for goodness sake.
Could you do one of those renderings where it's like 20 or 50 years in the future and like we see the full extent of that sag, like right before it falls off the bone?
Yeah, well, we definitely could be doing that. Definitely. Yeah, how about both of them, you know, on the little oak table, sitting there with the skin just sagging big time, like exaggerated. Yeah.
Yeah. Now we're talking.
That would be fun.
That's art.
Kind of like a dolly. Okay. You know, Dolly did a lot of that stuff.
That's true. Yeah, like a melting face clock.
Yeah. But instead of a melting face clock, it would be a melting Sean Penn, what's his name, face clock melt.
Yes, exactly. You took the words right out of my mouth.
Fantastic. All right. Well, thanks for the call.
Thank you. This has been illuminating.
It's been illuminating.
Has it? Oh, no.
Nanu. What?
Because we're on the subject of like art and film and movie stars, what was your favorite film this year?
I'm laughing because I'm laughing because I don't think I even saw a movie. I mean,
painting.
I've been painting too much. I mean, I've seen some movies, I guess, like on, I don't know, Netflix or something. Maybe I saw a movie on Netflix. I can't even tell you what movie I saw. I'd have to really think about it because I have not seen, I don't go to movie theaters.
Did you see Making a Murderer?
No. Is that a movie that came out last year or something?
It's a Netflix original series. I feel like you would throw a paintbrush at the television. It's phenomenal.
Nice.
It's very maddening.
You know, I did a whole series of movie reviews where I painted a scene from the movies and then gave a number of paintbrushes as, you know, how many paintbrushes are, you know, would be, 10 paintbrushes would be a really good movie kind of deal, you know.
Right, a scale.
Yeah, a scale. There is scale, yeah. Painted sweet. Scenes,
well,
painted
did anything
scenes.
Ever break, did anything ever break the scale or get
nah.
the
pen? Well, the thing is that I don't even see the movie and I'm just checking it out because it you know, I'm just maybe, I might see the trailer and then I just make up that I just end up saying the movie sucks and I just make shit up.
Yeah, I think there needs to be more trailer painting-based review shows.
Well, if you want to, yeah, exactly. If you want to go to my YouTube channel and look up painted scenes, you know, painted scenes. I did a whole series of those.
Cool. I'll check it out.
Yeah. I mean, they needed some work and needed some help and all, but there were some. It was fun. It was good times. Yeah, the trailers is all, you know, famously trailers are always tends to be, you know, that's the whole movie. That's it. That's all you need to know is just watch the trailer.
It's better than the movie.
Yeah. Like the last thing, perfect example is the J-Lo Ray Liotta television program that's out.
Yeah.
And the trailer or, you know, the ads for it are I guess kind of interesting. But then I actually ended up trying to watch it, and I couldn't get past 5 minutes. It was so boring and obvious about what was going down. You know, it's just like,
you know,
lame.
Really, Yoda's gonna pull a gun on her. Like, you just know that going in. So,
well, you just know it was
watching.
I don't know what I. Yeah, maybe I. Maybe he was or wouldn't. It has too many obvious scenarios. You know, oh, drug dealer. Oh, corrupt cops. Oh, New York City. Oh.
Oh, not even J-Lo and Ray Liotta could freshen that up.
Yeah, that is just lame. And then on the trailer, they have all these ads like Variety says such and such, how great. Oh, blah, 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 Hollywood Reporter. I'm like, are you kidding? No way. Yeah. All right, whatever.
I've been sort of mourning the loss of what I thought was going to be The Force Awakens. Like, I didn't hate The Force Awakens, but the trailer... just like it made me weep, you know, and that movie will never exist. That one that I made in my head.
Yeah, I don't even know what you're talking about. Is that like Star Wars stuff?
It is like Star Wars, yes.
Oh, yeah. I don't follow that stuff. I'm really. Yeah. I just don't get it.
You.
I never got it. I never got Star Wars. I'm sorry. I mean, I saw it, but I never. I saw Star Wars the first one, and that was it. I didn't need to see. You know, Star Wars 2 and 3 and whatever they call it. And
oh, man.
Yeah, I'm kind of...
I don't think I can relate to you anymore.
All right. See ya.
I'm going to hang up.
All right. I just killed a friendship right there. All right, well, I think that will be the last call, and unless someone wants to call here in the next second. And then I'll just time for me to for my epilogue. Time to sign out. Here in the next minute or two. So we're gonna do that. Thanks again. I'm gonna roll my end of the credit show thing here. So let's just watch that. And if you want to help support the program. We'll put your name in the credits. Hopefully that works. It looks like it's stuck. What's going on? Oh, here we go. So, Let's Paint TV credits. And I want to thank you all. This is the new supporters, people that have paid their dues. And if you want to help us out, you just go to patreon.com/letspainttv. We'll put your name in the credits. I did break his heart, didn't I? Anyway, that's it from here. I want to thank you all. I'm gonna clean up my house or my space or whatever, work on that and organize if I can. That's my job for today. Okay. What else happens on a Monday? One more call? Is that one more call? Do we got another call? One more call? One more call? Is there another call? Okay, that's it. Thanks again for being here, guys. Thanks for the calls. As mentioned before, I really enjoy the calls. But, all right, one more call. Hello, caller, what's your name? Where are you calling from?
Oh, it's me with the fan. I've got $1. If I do this dollar right now on the air, do you think we can update the credits as we go, or do it?
I could do that. I could do that, but you'd have to. We got.
Hold on. All right. How do I do it? Credit card?
I don't know. You just go to patreon.com/letspainttv.
Would you rather me do this off the air? I just thought it might be interesting to see it pop up different.
Yeah, I could work that out if you do it right now. I'll wait.
Okay, I gotta wait till it comes up again. I gotta see how to spell it. Patreon is a weird.
Yeah, it's
patreon.com.
Yeah, it's a very weird spelling here.
/ Let's Paint TV. Enter. They better have Visa or I'm screwed. Well,
yeah.
You're screwed, I guess.
I'll be screwed.
Oh, there you are.
Okay, there I am.
That's a good painting you have there. It's your thumbnail.
Oh. Okay.
Nice painting. Let me see. Continue. Man, how many options? Sign up and pledge. Oh, sign up with Facebook. I love when they have this because then I don't have to type in all my information.
Yeah, right.
My name's Charles, by the way. I called in a couple times today.
Okay,
Charles,
C-H-A-R-L-E-S?
Yeah. I had the laptop noise, but...
You want to be in the credits as Charles? Is that it? Or do you want another name?
I don't know. Do you think I should have my last name on there?
I don't know.
Probably not, huh?
I don't know. Some people do, some people don't.
Maybe I'll put my mom's maiden name that way. Then I know that it's me. But
okay,
but nobody can like find me or something.
Right. At least if we had like maybe your social security number or whatever you have. Do you have that up in Canada? Social security? What do you have?
Yeah, like? But we have like an extra number than you or something. Ours is 9 numbers.
Oh,
because
man.
9 is the number of completion. I know that you mentioned the Illuminati earlier.
Yeah.
9 is the completion number. It's a power number.
Nice. So that's why you guys are always on top of us. Canada.
Yeah, because we like it on top.
You guys
just roll over and go to bed.
Yeah.
I'm looking for my credit card right now. I'm not trying.
Uh-oh.
Hold on. Uh-oh. Oh, I found it. I'm wearing sweatpants. I couldn't feel it. Here we go. Wait, did you hear that slap down? That's the sound of cash.
Nice.
I do a little bit more, but
no, $1 is fine.
I just want to make sure.
My goal is to get 3,000 people, and then I'd be making $3,000 a month, kind of deal.
Right. Well, I told you before I want to commission you to make a painting. So
oh, okay.
I think maybe we could figure out something that way.
That too.
Hold on. Boom. Check your bank account, broski.
Really? Okay. Let me go take a look here.
I dropped a loony in your breast pocket.
Oh, here it is. All right, I got
you. You're wearing a chef hat. Man, that's worth a dollar right there.
Yeah. That's my bakery coming up.
I just want to let you know that I check my credit card statement all the time. If I see $10 to the left paint TV, that's not a good, you know, back and forth thing we'd have going here. It's a trust exercise.
No. It's only going to be $1. It will show up as $1. Hey,
okay.
You change it. So should I put it down? How should I sign up?
How should
I give you credit? How do you want to go?
Hold on. I'm going to make up a fake last name.
All right.
So I'm going to be Charles Still, which is my first name.
All right.
And then let's go W A L L.
Wait.
I S.
Okay. Let's see here.
Charles Wallace.
Okay.
Wallace.
Okay, Charles, W A L L
I S.
I S. Okay. W A L L I S. That's it. Well, good, right?
That's me. I'm looking at this scroll, though.
Okay, I'm not there yet. I have it in my Final Cut Pro situation. And it's
You can change the font, right? You don't have to have Arial Bold.
Oh, okay. What should I go for?
Man.
Gil Sands is what it is.
Gil Sands, please. Gil Sands, please.
That's what I have. I have Gil Sands.
Let's do it.
No, that's what it is. That is Gil Sands.
Yeah, I'm with that.
Okay. So that's what it is. Okay, so now I'm going to send it out.
So is it $1 a month or did I just hit you?
It's $1 a month. It just automatically sucks you down $1 a month until you get rid of it. Or until I get rid of it. I was thinking of getting rid of it altogether because I might actually have to, depending on what's going down here in the next month or so. The weird stuff's going down here, Let's Paint TV, let me tell you. All right, so.
Well, I don't know who the other guy was from. You said that you think we all know each other. That was just weird that those other people called
Well,
trouble, but
I don't,
you told one of them not.
Yeah.
You told one of them that you might not do this anymore, but you really can't do that. I've been watching you since the beginning.
Yeah, I know. I'm still doing it. I keep saying that I might be doing it on another kind of,
avenue,
a portal. Yeah. It could be completely crazy, different, big time, whatever, but it might not actually happen. So until anything does happen, I'm here. Okay. So
am I going underneath Bongo?
Yeah, you're going underneath Bongo. You'll be underneath Bongo. So let me go here.
All right.
Let me, Save. Right. I'm saving.
So, I guess I'll be under Bongo. Yeah, I mean, I only paid $1. I can't ask for much.
Yeah, yeah, you'll be fine. You'll be fine. Bongo's good. You'll like Bongo. Bongo's a good guy. Okay, so let me add the next. Might take a second.
You can update this live?
Yeah, but I am, but it's just going to take, it should be quicker, but it isn't. I mean, this is about as, I am no whiz.
You have no
wind
in the wind column?
Okay, it's going to work. I'm not a whiz in terms of doing things.
Oh.
And computer. I'm not a computer whiz. Okay, so let's go ahead.
Black and yellow.
Here we go. Khalifa. Let me get rid of this shot, delete shot, boom.
I just keep seeing the credit scroll. Oh, there you are. We're back in the studio, baby.
Back in the studio, but let me bring in the new shot, new video, add new shot, because see, I had to update, and then here is our new updated.
I drank some coffee since last time we talked. I can feel like I'm a little more on edge. I'm sorry. I'm not.
That's all right. So now, here we go. Ready?
Ready.
You're running it, baby. You've just run the tables.
And I guess that's why they call it the blues. Time on my hands, could be time spent with you. Laughing like children, living like lovers. Roll, there I am.
We got you down. We did it.
All right, bro, man.
All right.
Take that dollar, go get a waste paper basket, and I'm gonna see you tomorrow.
I know you bought that waste paper basket from the 99-cent store.
Will you put my name on it? Will you write Charles on a piece of paper?
I will do that for you. Yes.
I will give you another dollar. Another pledge as soon as I get paid.
All right.
Your waste paper basket will always say Charles.
All right.
Or at least for a little while.
All right.
All right, bro.
All right. Take care, buddy. Oops, I lost him. Okay. I think that is going to be it. I'm going to just double one more check here on our live dashboard. Okay, not much going on. Okay, you guys still watching and all, but this is it. There's really no debate about it. I am signing off. Thanks again, guys, for being here. Thanks for picking up my support. Thanks for being my jockstrap. And that's it. Okay. I'll run the credits one more time. What the heck? One more time. Bye-bye, everybody.